And now for Mark Walker's regular weekend football review with Danny Di Vito. Brighton Hove Albion lost 1-0 at home in a South Coast derby to Southampton in a crucial relegation fight, while Whitehawk, also fighting relegation, lost 2-0 at home to Bishop Stortford.
So I'm joined here today for our regular football review by Danny Di Vito, and we're going to be reviewing the Whitehawk and the Brighton Hove Albion games.
Hello, Mark.
Right, welcome back. So we obviously the Whitehawk game. It was a 2-0 loss at home to Bishop Stortford. So what's going wrong for the Hawks? Because that's a succession of bad results now, isn't it?
Yeah, it's, we've had four losses now. We did have four wins at our own. It was very disappointing, the game. I felt we had a lot of opportunities to win the game. Things didn't go our way. We give away two very silly goals.
What's next for the Hawks? And they've got five games to go. They're on 34 points. They're back in the relegation places, third from bottom. So what's next?
Well, next they've got Folkestone on Saturday. This is a winnable game. Like I said, they had good mentality this last game they played against Bishops. They've really got to start scoring.
Yeah.
The strikers just ain't putting it in the net, and they've got to be clinical at this point.
And what's the running like? What's the running like for the Hawks?
I wouldn't say it's brilliant, but it's not super hard. But yeah, right. they plug on, they can get, they're winnable some of the games. I'd say we still need a good three games. If we could win those three games.
So 9 points.
Yeah, then you'd be quite more cosy than we are now.
Yeah, okay, and that put them on 43 points. Do you think 43 points might be enough?
I think so, yeah.
Right, okay. Mm. Moving on to the Albion then. Obviously, I was there on Saturday, South Coast Derby to Southampton. Obviously, we lost 1-0, and it was a bit of a disappointing game, really, for me. A lot of the time, Brighton didn't really like scoring, particularly until Lacardia came on in the second half. Brighton got a big bailout from Cardiff City losing at home. Controversially at home to Chelsea. So we're still 5 points away from the last relegation places, but we've still got three winnable home games, Bournemouth, Newcastle, and we've got Cardiff City as well, which I think will be a crucial game. Have you got any thoughts on the Albion game?
Yeah, I still think, even though we've got, like you said, they're almost like bankers possibly, like the other three games that look easier.
Well, Southampton might have been a banker as well.
You've got to remember these teams are all fighting for relegation as well. So, any of these games is going to be hard, So, targeting just them games is still a gamble. I feel he's still got to target the bigger teams. They've obviously got Chelsea in midweek. Even these teams, you can get things from them. I mean, look at what Newcastle done against Man City. They got 3 points, and you've got to have that mentality that you can get points from anywhere this time of the season.
Yeah. Very lastly, it's been really controversial refereeing decisions, and particularly the Cardiff game against Chelsea. I mean, what are your views on... I mean, the offside was, it's blatant offside, and then a blatant red card, really, as well, Rudiger.
Right.
Bringing down the striker.
Yeah.
What are your thoughts on that?
Well, referees are just terrible these days, aren't they? You can't do a lot about it, really, So we're going to bring in the technology.
We need VAR. Team,
possibly, it could help.
Saturday's, Sunday's game, Cardiff City, I think that was a clear example of why the Premiership needs VAR.
So. I agree with you, yeah.
Okay, thanks, Danny, for coming in.
Thanks,
and we'll catch up again next Monday.
Thank you. Cheers.